news, it's me, Alicia. Happy Thursday and happy third week of Cultivate Plus Devotions. You're more than halfway through. Good job, everybody. Today's topic will be on despair versus hope. And without further ado, let's jump right in. Despair means the complete loss of hope, while hope is the desire for a particular thing to happen. Putting it into perspective, we despair when we give up on a certain circumstance because we feel that nothing will work out. And we have hope when we expect and want things to work out. I believe we have all felt despair in our life before, myself included, be it in studies, friendships, relationships, or even at ourselves. We all go through periods where we might be stuck in a rut, going through trials and suffering that frustrates us, and we want to give up. So how can we move out and forward from our valley of despair? And have hope when it seems like nothing is working out? Today, let's take a look at 2 Corinthians 1 verse 3 to 11, where it tells of Paul's despair and consolation. All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is our merciful Father and the source of all comfort. He comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort others. When they are troubled, we will be able to give the same comfort God has given us. For the more we suffer for Christ, the more God will shower us with His comfort through Christ. Even when we are being weighed down with troubles, it is for your comfort and salvation. For we ourselves are comforted, we will certainly comfort you. Then you can patiently endure the same things we suffer. We are confident that as you share in our sufferings, you will also share in the comfort God gives us. You see, in Paul's suffering, he was able to experience consolation abundant by God through Christ. And he wanted to share this with the Corinthians because he was sure that the Corinthians were undoubtedly going to suffer for Christ's sake. Paul suffered, but he did not despair. He did not lose hope because his hope was based on the knowledge that God was ultimately in control of it all, and his suffering would have meaning for all eternity. As children of God, we should not grieve in whatever way we want and use it as an excuse to sin, such as swearing, gossiping, bringing people down, alcoholism, and drowning in our sorrows and pities, because these are acts that show that we are grieving like those who have no hope. But as Christians, our glorious Savior who died is coming again. There is greater comfort available to every one of you. There is hope. Moving on, verse 8. We think you ought to know, dear brothers and sisters, about the trouble we went through in the province of Asia. We were crushed and overwhelmed beyond our ability to endure, and we thought we would never live through it. In fact, we expected to die. But as a result, we stopped relying on ourselves and learned to rely only on God, who raises the dead. And He did rescue us from mortal danger, and He will rescue us again. We have placed our confidence in Him, and He will continue to rescue us. And you are helping us by praying for us. Then many people will give thanks because God has graciously answered so many prayers for our safety. Paul gave us a practical example of his suffering in Asia. And just like how we may face trials and suffering, be crushed and overwhelmed beyond our ability to endure on earth, it is inevitable. However, the key point is this. We know that Paul depends only on God to get him through. He directed his distress towards God. In life, as we go through the different ups and downs, it is okay to occasionally weep over the life we hope would be. But what matters more is to wash our faces, trust God, and embrace the life that we have. Have hope. As we cry for help to the God of comfort, we are allowing God to take away our sadness, distress, and exchange it for peace that is in the promise of God in Matthew 5:4. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. We do not need to beat ourselves up when we feel despair. Our problems, suffering, and afflictions can feel like they could crush us to the point where we feel despair. But we do not need to feel that way. Paul, a man chosen by God to preach the gospel to the known world, went through exactly the same feeling. If today your life is not what you hope for, if you have suffered from the loss of dreams or loved ones, I cannot guarantee the change in your circumstances. Storms will still come our way, but God will wipe away every single tear from our eyes. We can hold on to the precious and great promises of God, that He hears and answers us as we pray. He will never forsake us, nor leave us. He will satisfy our hearts with joy in Him forever, and He will keep us from stumbling so that we can stand before Him, blameless and full of joy. The hope that we have does not eliminate tears, but it does redeem them. So grieve in hope, wash our faces, and keep walking by faith. Life may not be storm-free, but with God, it is storm-proof. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we give thanks for your word today. We give thanks for how you have carried us through life, through the ups and downs. And in the days to come, in the ups and downs, we pray, Lord, that you continue to help us to have hope and to continue to grieve with hope, O Lord, and stay by your word. All this we give thanks in Jesus' name. Amen.